Vice President of India, respected Sri Venkaiah Naidu ji, who is going to release this book daily. Chief Minister of Mizoram, Sri Zoramtanga ji, who has given a video message for this program. The real celebrity of today's evening, a friend, philosopher, guide to many, but Honorable Governor of Mizoram, Dr. Sridhan Pillai, a prolific scholar who happened to be a politician, Dr. Jitendra Singh. I haven't seen many people having so thorough knowledge about particular issues with a research perspective. If you really want to listen about it, and I would like to have, at least in personal conversation, his take on DDC elections and Jammu Kashmir. But now he has developed a similar kind of expertise on Northeast also, as a charge of the police. And Dr. V.P. Joy, who is Secretary Coordination Cabinet. Friends, ladies and gentlemen, it is my real privilege to introduce this book. I don't know why Sridhartan chose me, because I am generally a person who comes from prose and not from poetry. But still, the way Dr. Pillai has communicated through poetry in this particular book is no less than any form of conversation. And I'm deliberately talking conversation, because it is a clear-cut conversation with himself, conversation with the things happening around, and still he is communicating something to the reader. Because when we talk about the Kavya, there are two prolific definitions that I always interview, and that's why I stay away from poetry generally. One is given by Santa Gyaneshwar, who started the Bhakti movement, and he gave one important criteria for being a poet and a good poetry. He said, "Yar dai che tyar dai ghatile." You know, taking right from right heart to the right soul, that is poetry. And Hindi they say, "Jo na dekhe Ravi wo dekhe Kavi." Thing even the sun cannot observe, poet can observe. So being a journalist, you know, this is very difficult thing to do. So, but what Dr. Pillai has done through this book are very interesting things. One I really liked, and you can see that from page one. Everybody knows about his ideological background, cultural moorings. Even in poetry, you can clearly see that seeds of cultural nationalism coming out, whether in the form of Namaste, whether in the form of the kind of struggle that India has taken in its fight against the pandemic. Everywhere, that natural sense of cultural nationalism is reflected in his poetry. The dedication is to respected late Parameshwar ji, and I perfectly understand his sentiments for this dedication. And that is one of the reasons that, you know, I got engaged with this book. There is a philosophical depth and still a very sensitive mind in this poetry. And I'll just cite one thing. You know, he's talking about the cycle of a flower. given a very in-depth message of the mission they fulfill while blossoming. It is a message for life also. He is talking about the nature, as Sri Dattan rightly mentioned, but at the same time, he is talking about the colonization process that has taken place and the word that he has used, from white man's burden to white man's blunder. That is one of the best ways to explain the way we have colonized intellectually, psychologically, and even emotionally. It is very refreshing to read poetry in English with such in-depth appreciation for Indic cultural setting and this urge to come out of this colonial mindset. And rightly, he has dedicated this poetry to the state which he is heading constitutionally today. Because throughout the poetry, you can see the rustic Sridharan Pillai coming from some village of Kerala, and as if as a personal journey he is travelling to Mizoram, and the way Mizoram embraced him, the way culturally and as a tourist destination also the way he has seen Mizoram, he is giving a call in a way which is not just a political message but a national message of Ek Bharat Shrestha Bharat. The most important thing, and rightly he has given the title dedicated to his poem, Om, is pain sometimes, but more importantly, it is also poetic wisdom that Dr. Sridharan Pillai has given us through this poetry. So I congratulate Indoscrolls on this occasion. I am really grateful, sir, for doing this for the readers in English now. And I really wish that this book does well, not just for Indoscrolls or Sridharan Pillai doesn't need any book to do good, because he has achieved a lot as an author also. But for us as readers, I think it is a new way to look at ourselves, the things around, the nature, and of course, a call to visit North. Thank you. Thanks a lot. And you know, I really wish best for this book.